Ralph Waldo Emerson once observed, "What is a weed? A plant whose virtues have not yet been discovered." Well, it's time to discover the virtues of the dandelion as I set out to make some dandelion wine. It might come as a surprise to many of you, but before the English settlers came to this country, there were no dandelions to be found. They brought them over intentionally to plant in their gardens, as they knew that this plant was powerful. The leaves could be made into salads, the roots could be roasted into coffee, and of course the petals could be made into wine, as well as honey and jam. It didn't take long for the dandelions to take over. As early as the 1660s, the dandelions carpeted many a field. In fact, John Jocelyn compiled a list noting of such plants as have sprung up since the English planted and kept cattle in New England. Among them are the dandelion. The Native Americans were so in awe of the new flowers and plants that were appearing after the settlers came that they often called the Englishman a botanical Midas, able to change the landscape with the various flora. But today is a day to reclaim the beauty of the weed. What is a weed? It's simply a plant whose virtues have not yet been discovered. And so, my friends, welcome to Old Stonewall Farm.
Well, there's a homesteading fair going on this weekend right across the border in New York State, and it's the first time ever they're doing such an event like that. There's a whole group of people now that are new to the area and are very passionate about learning the skills of homesteading. The classes are everything from canning, how to kill a chicken and prepare it to eat it. There's not anything mentioned about making dandelion wine. Now, this has been fermenting for a few days, and I think it has to ferment for a lot longer, but I have to tell you, my friends, it is absolutely delicious. It's starting to have a kick to it. I wanted to go to the homesteading festival because I think that I know that there are a lot of things that I need to learn that I have no clue what I'm doing. Even this wine, I'm sure that I missed a step or two. I wanted to attend it because I wanted to really perfect the skills of providing for my family, providing for myself and for my husband. And I was joking around the other day as he's working on the outdoor bake oven around that I can make bread, I can make butter, I've made homemade farmer's cheese, and now I have homemade wine. And of course we have eggs from the chickens. So I can prepare for anyone of you who comes to visit me here at Old Stonewall Farm, I can prepare for you a very simple but very filling meal. Dandelions. Oh my gosh, where do I begin about dandelions? Just this morning, I was outside gathering a whole bunch of lilacs before the heavy winds and the rain comes. And as I had this big armful of the most fragrant flowers, I was just so happy. And the memories came back, the memories of picking lilacs for my mother for Mother's Day, and just so many wonderful flashbacks to childhood. But the dandelion doesn't have such wonderful memories attached to it. There was a few years ago when I was still living in New Jersey and I was just ordained as a pastor, and we had this hiking trip with the kids of the church, and it was early spring, it was in May, and there was this big field filled with dandelions. I was standing next to this little girl, and she was with her mother, and this little girl was just so mesmerized by this field blanketed with yellow flowers, and her eyes got really wide, and she was like, "Mommy, look at all these flowers, they're just so beautiful." The little girl saw such potential for a beautiful bouquet for her mother. But that's when her mother looked out where the girl was looking and said, "Honey, those are weeds. Don't you dare pick me any of those." The girl looked so sad, and I was kind of sad too. Well, when I came up to upstate New York in the Vermont area as a pastor, and I remember my first spring here, and I looked out at the field and I kind of mentioned, wow, you have a lot of weeds. That's when an old farmer's wife looked at me and she said, those aren't weeds. That's a field full of provision. It's a field full of hope. That's a field full of yummy, delectable items for a salad. That's a field full of dandelion wine. That is God providing for us. And it got me thinking more and more how we are brought up and we are taught what are weeds in life. We are often conditioned as to what is worthy in life and what isn't. I think that when we are born with eyes that are pure to see God. We are born with eyes that have the ability to see the holy, to see the beauty. And yet, as we get older, we get conditioned to see things differently. We no longer can see with the eyes of God, but we see what the world sees and what the world tells us to see. Dandelions are so underrated. They are not a weed, but they are a beautiful plant. But yet, as we get older, we fail to see the beauty, not just in a dandelion, but we fail to see the beauty and the potential in one another. I am a pastor and a writer, but most of my church career has been in small churches, small rural churches. And as I was picking all of these dandelions to try my hand at dandelion wine, I kept thinking of the small church as a dandelion. For far too long, these rural churches have been looked at as not worthy, not redeemable. These small churches are looked at as, well, they're just dying. There's nothing worthwhile in them. And yet these rural churches, they scatter our landscape all throughout the country. They scatter our landscape like dandelions. There's a little congregational church here in Rupert, and behind it was a field of dandelions. And one day, as I was passing, I just kind of looked, and here's this New England looking old church and all these dandelions. And it was just a powerful moment for me when I made that connection that we today view our struggling churches as dandelions and often not worthy to be saved. And yet, as I was making the wine, I kept thinking about what Jesus said that we are to make new wine. And when we make new wine, we don't put it in old wineskins because that will just destroy it and ruin it and just tarnish it. No, we are to make new wine and place it in new wineskins. Perhaps our rural churches are that new wine that God is wanting for us. Perhaps those churches that we think have no potential really do have a lot of potential and can teach us a few things about what it means to be together in Christ, to show up for one another. Maybe these small churches, like the dandelion, shouldn't be overlooked as useless and a weed and just not worthy, but looked at as something that is holding great potential, something that is providing for society, something that can create the most beautiful, beautiful new wine. Our small churches are alive. Yes, they're struggling. But they're struggling because they are still holding on to what they think is church. They're struggling because they're still trying to put new wine into old wineskins. They're struggling because they need to rethink, reimagine what church can be. This batch of dandelion wine is a very small batch because I didn't realize how many petals it took. It was just the heads that you plucked off and you soaked. But no, it was the actual petals that you had to pluck and soak. So it took me a while just to get a little bit of wine. But as I was doing the hard work of plucking the petals and making sure there wasn't too much of the green stem, because that could make the wine bitter, I was thinking a lot about how in this world, to really get to the good stuff, to really create something amazing, to really have a life that is worthwhile, it does take patience and it takes work, and sometimes it seems very tedious. But each and every day you show up and you do the work of making this world a better place. You do the work of loving, you do the work of listening, you do the work of being patient with others. But I also realized if I never said yes to a small, struggling rural church so many years ago, I never, ever would have learned how beautiful dandelions are. The next time you see a dandelion, instead of cursing it or plucking it and throwing it away, take a moment and look at it and think about the amazing potential in that plant. And then think about your life. Standing in a field of so many things that are vying for our attention, standing in a field of so many others that we compare ourselves to, and then realizing that God is looking down at you and doesn't see a weed, but sees the beauty and the potential inside. So embrace the dandelion, and I cannot talk enough about this dandelion wine. I think I will try my hand at making rhubarb wine. And I just might try to make it to the homesteading convention because I still want to learn how to can, and don't laugh at me, but I still want to learn how to process a chicken. I know. Do have the heart to kill a chicken, but I don't know. I just think that a nice chicken dinner for Sunday would be really a great way to end the weekend. Of course, don't tell my chickens this. They might not like it. God bless.
May God give you eyes to see all that is good, all that is good, the courage for anything. May you be strong, may you be strong.
And after the yellow petals of the dandelions become these white fluffy balls, I can't help but to smile, for I now walk a field of wishes. As a little girl, I used to blow on them to make a wish. And now, as an adult, I walk through this field, remembering that God wants to hear our desires, our dreams, and our wishes.